Hello everyone, welcome to the session on number systems. Let us have a quick look at the session plan. Topics covered are classification of number system, Venn diagram, different types of number system, fun facts, types of numbers, properties of real numbers, Bodmer's rule, and few illustrations. In this section, let us revisit your school days discussing classification of number systems. We begin the classification with natural numbers. These numbers are also called the counting numbers, starting from 1, 2, 3 and so on. The next set of number is whole numbers, which include 0 along with all natural numbers, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. Integers are negative and non-decimal numbers, including the set of whole numbers. Rational numbers are the numbers expressed in the form p by q, where p and q are integers and q is not equal to 0. All integers are rational numbers as they can be expressed in the form p by q and q is not equal to 0. Rational numbers include fractions as well. Irrational numbers are those numbers which are not rational. These are the numbers which have non-repeating, non-terminating decimals. Square root of 2, pi, the golden ratio phi, which is widely used in stock market analysis, are few examples of irrational numbers. Real numbers are all rational numbers and irrational numbers put together. Imaginary numbers are numbers expressed as a square root of a negative number. Complex numbers are polynomials expressed as a plus bi, where a and b are real numbers and I is imaginary number. For example, 2 plus 3i. I'm sure you must have observed in the Venn diagram that the set of natural number is the smallest set of numbers, a subset of whole numbers. Set of whole numbers in turn is contained in the set of integers. Set of integers is a subset of set of rational numbers. Set of rational and irrational numbers are subset of real numbers. Set of complex number constitute superset of real and imaginary numbers. The classification of numbers discussed earlier in the Venn diagram has been explained with decimal number system. There are other number systems too. In this section, let us have a look at different types of number systems. Before we visit other number systems, let us understand the concept of base of a number system. The base of a number system is nothing but the number of different unique digits or symbols used in the number system to express its numbers. Let us understand this concept extended to different number systems. The decimal system comprises of 10 basic symbols or digits 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. The base of decimal number system therefore is 10. Each of the digit in a number has a value or importance 10 times greater than the digit just to its right. For example, 483 in decimal number system, reading from right would mean 3 log of 1 units, which is equal to 3, 8 log of 10, which is equal to 80, 4 log of 100, which is equal to 400, totaling to 483. The binary system, as the name suggests, has only two digits, 0 and 1. The base of the system is therefore 2. In this number system, each of the digits in a number is twice the value of the digits on its right. For example, 1001 in binary system, reading from right to left would mean 1 log of 1 equal to 1, 0 log of 2 equal to 0, 0 log of 4 equal to 0, 1 log of 8 equal to 8, totaling to 9 in decimal system. The octal number system comprises of 8 digits 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. The base of the number system is therefore 8. In this number system, each of the digits in a number is 8 times the value of the digits on its right. For example, 543 in octal number system, reading from right to left would mean 3 log of 1 equal to 3, 4 log of 8 equal to 32, 5 log of 64 equal to 320, total into 355 in decimal system. The hexadecimal system comprises of 16 digits, that is 0 to 9 and A, B, C, D, E, F. The base of the number system therefore is 16. In this number system, each of the digits in a number is 16 times the value of the digit on its right. For example, 8F2 in hexadecimal number system, reading from right to left would be 2 log of 1, which is equal to 2, F15 log of 16 equal to 240, 8 log of 256 equal to 2048, which amounts to 2290 in decimal system. Let us look at some fun facts about history of irrational numbers. Apparently, Hipposis, one of the students of mathematician Pythagoras, discovered irrational numbers when trying to write the square root of 2 as a fraction using geometry, it is thought. Instead, he proved that one couldn't write the square root of 2 as a fraction, and so it was irrational. But followers of Pythagoras could not accept the existence of irrational numbers, and it is said that Hipposis was drowned in the sea as a punishment from the gods. Let's have a look at few types of numbers we generally come across. Even numbers are numbers divisible by 2, for example 16, 20. Odd numbers are the numbers which are not even, for example 5, 7. Prime number is a number which is divisible by itself and 1, for instance 2, 3. 2 is the only even number which is prime. Composite number is a number which is not a prime number, for example 8, 9. Perfect number is a number whose factors sum to the number itself, for example 6 and 28. Let us have a look at properties of real number. Commutative property of addition and multiplication. According to this property, numbers can be added or multiplied in any order with no impact on resulting answer, as in A plus B equal to B plus A, A into B equal to B into A. Associative property of addition and multiplication. According to this property, numbers could be added or multiplied irrespective of their grouping in an expression, resulting in same answer. The word grouping here means how parentheses are used in an expression being evaluated. Thus, while adding or multiplying, the place where parentheses are put does not matter, as in A plus B within bracket plus C equal to A plus B plus C within bracket, and A multiplied with B within bracket multiplied with C equal to A multiplied with within bracket B multiplied with C. Distributive property. According to this property, while multiplying a number by the sum of the two numbers, the former number is distributed to both latter numbers and multiplied by each one of the latter separately. The answer obtained by adding the two products together gives the same result as multiplying the former by the sum of the two latter numbers, as in A into B plus C within bracket equal to A into B plus A into C. Identity property. According to identity property for addition, 0 added to any number gives the number itself. 0 is called the additive identity. The identity property for multiplication implies that any number multiplied by 1 gives the number itself. 1 is called multiplicative identity, as in A plus 0 equal to A and A multiplied with 1 equal to A. inverse property. For addition, it implies that any number added to its inverse is equal to zero. Inverse property of multiplication implies that any number multiplied by its reciprocal equals 1, as in a plus minus a equal to 0 and a multiplied with 1 upon a equal to 1. Let us now revisit our school days and revise the Bodmer's rule. According to Bodmer's rule, in an expression containing brackets, the brackets are simplified or solved first, followed by order operator, powers and roots, etc., and then division, multiplication, and addition and subtraction from left to right. Let us look at few illustration of Bodmer's rule. In illustration 1, we are computing the expression 5 plus 2 multiplied with minus 3. Here are the two approaches to the computational steps. As you can see, in step 1, approach 1 computes multiplication of 2 and minus 3, while approach 2 computes addition of 5 and 2. In step 2, approach 1 computes addition of 5 and minus 6, while approach 2, it computes multiplication of 7 and minus 3. Step 3 gives the result of computation from both the approaches. Which of the approach of computation is correct? I am sure you must have guessed it. As you can see, the correct answer is obtained using approach 1, which follows the Bodmer's rule by considering the right order of computation, that is multiplication followed by addition. Let us look now at illustration 2. Where expression 20 divided by 4 plus 6 multiplied with minus 5 plus 45 is being computed. As you can see, step 1 first computes the division 20 divided by 4. Step 2 computes multiplication 6 multiplied with minus 5. Step 3 computes the addition 5 plus minus 30. Step 4 computes the addition minus 25 plus 45. Step 5 gives the result of computation. I am sure you would have noted that applicable Bodmer's rule for each step is shown in red color in the associated rule column. Let us now look at illustration 3, where expression 27 divided by 3 plus 4 square multiplied with within bracket minus 10 plus 65 is being computed. As you can see, step 1 computes the bracket minus 10 plus 65. Step 2 computes the order or the power, that is 4 square. Step 3 computes the division 27 divided by 3. Step 4 computes the addition 9 plus 16. Step 5 computes the addition 25 plus 55. Step 6 gives the result of computation. Now let us look at few application of Bodmer's in finance. Illustration 4 shows the application of Bodmer's in path breaking model, that is capital asset pricing model, for arriving at required rate of return of assets in capital market. The associated formula being RI equal to RF plus beta multiplied with RM minus RF, and the expression computed being 0.03 plus 0.8 multiplied with within bracket 0.1 minus 0.03. As you can see, step 1 first computes the bracket 0.1 minus 0.03. Step 2 computes the multiplication, that is 0.8 multiplied with 0.07. Step 3 computes the addition 0.03 plus 0.056. Step 4 gives the result of computation. Let us look at illustration 5, which is the application of Bodmer's rule in constant growth dividend discount model of finance for arriving at the value of the share. The associated formula being P0 equal to D0 multiplied with within bracket 1 plus g whole divided by within bracket k minus g. And the expression being computed, 15 multiplied with inner bracket 1 plus 0.05 divided by 0.14 minus 0.05 within brackets. As you can see, step 1 computes the inner bracket 1 plus 0.05. Step 2 computes the outer bracket 15 multiplied with 1.05 and 0.14 minus 0.05. Step 3 computes the division 15.75 divided by 0.09. Step 4 gives the result of computation. That is 175 is the value of the share. To better assimilate the concept discussed in this session, you may please visit the URL and the documentation referred in the slide. Should you need help, you may please reach me on my mail or voice coordinates shared on the IBS LMS portal. Thank you.